Welcome to Kampala Bible Revelation Church, located at Makerere 1, Okubira Zone. Pastor Hanning Mutukiriza and other servants of God welcome you to a ministry based on the Word of God. We have a covenant with God for placement and multiplication according to Ezekiel 37 verse 26 to 28. Welcome to our Sunday services, which impact believers with transformational revelations from the Word of God. Our Thursday midweek service is a series of teachings equipping believers with practical skills from the Word of God. Testimonies of God's goodness abound. You can also join our Doers of the Word Bible Institute, where God's children have been ground into God's Word and empowered with a practical approach to transformation, both spiritually and physically, totally free of charge. We are located at Makerere 1, Mukubira Zone, near Makerere Business Institute, along Sapolo Kagwa Road. You are welcome.
Jesus, the Prince of Peace. I want you to repeat after me. Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That means Jesus has customized. I've seen vehicles. Amen. Mine is not customized, but the peace we are talking about is customized. Hallelujah. Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Amen.
Amen.
The Prince of Peace. Hallelujah. God wants to open our eyes today. The peace we are talking about that comes from God is different from the peace we know. We have heard from history. We have been promised peace. People have died for peace. Hallelujah. And the peace we know, where there is no war, you call it peace. Okay, I will allow. Amen. The peace we know is of environment. How is the environment? Amen. When you hear about terrorism, you say, "Ah, this place is insecure." But what I want to tell you, the peace we are talking about is far above. Hallelujah. It's far above the peace of state, the peace of no war. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Listen, the peace that God wants you to understand, peace comes from God. Hallelujah. Peace comes from God. God wants you to understand that this month He has brought it for a purpose. Some of us, we are so used because they have told us, "I brought peace. We have fought for peace because there is no war." Now, what kind of peace is God talking about? Do you need peace in your marriage? Do you need peace in your finances? Do you need peace in your ministry? Do you need peace in your locality? Hallelujah. Do you need peace? God has come out clearly. Peace comes from God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Peace comes from God. In our very handout, Romans 1:7, it says, "To all that be in Rome, beloved of God, called to be saints, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ." Peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I want this thing to be embedded in your mind. The peace you are talking about is from God. Hallelujah. It's from God. Amen. The peace we are talking about is from God. And the Bible tells us, anything that comes from above is above all. Amen? Because it's coming from God. It is above. It is above. So we are not talking about just peace. that you know where there is no terrorism, where there is security. No, the peace we are talking about is from God, and it is above all. And he says, every good gift and perfect gift comes from above. This is coming from God. It is good. It is perfect. You need it in your home.
Amen.
You need this peace.
Amen.
In your finances. You need this peace in your ministry. You need it in spite of no war. Hallelujah. In spite of no terrorism in your area, this peace is superior. Hallelujah. It is above all. It is good. It is perfect. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's not the same as the world. It's not the same. Amen. It's not the same. That's why Jesus is called the Prince of Peace. It was customized. It belongs to him. Hallelujah. You can't get it anywhere. Whether you go to America, whether you go to China, it is still the Prince of Peace. Hallelujah. Whether you come to State House, it is still the Prince of Peace. It is customized. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This peace that comes from God is so different. It's so different. Isaiah 90 is a very on our handout, second page. It says, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his names shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Hallelujah. The peace we are talking about is governed by a prince. Hallelujah. He has authority over it. It is his. He is a Prince of Peace. Hallelujah. That's why it's different from the worldly peace. Amen. The peace of God is tangible. It is tangible. Hallelujah. It is what?
Tangible.
Tangible. Listen. When Jesus sent his disciples to preach. Let's read there. Luke 10. One says, and these things the Lord appointed other 70 also, and sent them two and two before his face, and to every city, place where himself would come. Okay? Let's come to three. Go your ways. Behold, I send you forth as lambs among wolves. He's sending you where? As a lamb among wolves. Therefore, he says, carry neither pass, neither script, neither shoes, and salute no man by the way. Five. And in whatsoever house you enter, first say, peace be to this house. Peace. Without anything. Hallelujah. He has said, carry nothing. There are some people here, they have nothing. Hallelujah. I have good news for you. The peace you have will provide everything that you need this month in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. They had nothing but only peace. He said, and into whatsoever house you enter, first say, peace be to this house. Six. And if the Son of Peace be there, hallelujah, your peace shall rest upon it. If not, it shall come back. That's how powerful the peace you carry. That's how powerful the peace of God it is. You can release it, it can come back. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The peace of God is different. It is tangible. Amen. It is a force. Hallelujah. Let's look Mark 4. verses 35. You know the story. Jesus said, he got in the boat and said, let us pass over unto the other side. Okay? You are crossing over. I don't know whether you have businesses, you want to go to another level. Amen? Listen to this story. 37. And there arose a great storm. Is there a storm in your life? Is there a storm in your marriage? Is there a storm in your finances? Listen. The Bible tells us Jesus was in the hinder part of the ship asleep. Hallelujah. Asleep. Amen. Then they came and told him that they are perishing. 39 says, and he arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace be still. In the name of Jesus, I want to decree any wind, any storm in your life, peace be still in the name of Jesus. Peace be still in the name of Jesus. Listen, and the wind ceased. And there was a great calm. I prophesy great calm in your marriage today in Jesus' name. I prophesy great calm in your finances in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Be said, peace, be still. It is a force. Hallelujah. It's a force. Amen. It's not ordinary as we think. It is a force. Hallelujah. I see your story changing today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The peace we are talking about is not the ordinary peace. It's not the peace of the world. Hallelujah. It is peace from above. It is the peace from God. Hallelujah. It can stop the storm. It will stop your storm in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I am not ashamed to prophesy that this month you are stepping where you have never stepped. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Because of peace. Hallelujah. Amen. Listen. Listen. Some person is here. Troubled. Say, I don't understand what you are talking about. You know the story of Pharaoh. The time of Joseph. Joseph was in prison. Some people may be in prison. Hallelujah. Pharaoh dreamed. He got troubled. Some people are troubled. They are troubled. They are troubled. See, how will I make it? Financially. How will I make it? My children. How will I make it? My husband. How will I make it? My boss is troubled. When Joseph was called before the king, he said, the king should not get worried. Hallelujah. Do you know the statement he told him? Do you want to read? Hallelujah. You are looking at me. Hallelujah. Let's go to Genesis 41. Genesis 41. What does it say? And it will be so with you. 41 verses 16. And Joseph answered Pharaoh. You may have to answer your situation today. It is not in me. God shall give you an answer of peace. There is an answer of peace coming your way today in Jesus' name. An answer of peace. Some people don't understand it. An answer of peace. Here is a man, he was troubled. He dreamed, he could not understand. Some of you here, you are troubled. You don't understand. I have good news for you. There is an answer of peace before the end of this sermon in the name of Jesus. An answer of peace. When God speaks, he speaks peace. Hallelujah. He speaks peace. An answer of peace is yours today in Jesus' name. In that situation, however bad There is an answer of peace coming your way. You will not die. You will live to declare his words in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. That is an answer of peace. You will not die. Have you been troubled? The doctors have said no. Just like Pharaoh, a king, dreamed it was impossible. He couldn't know what would befall him. But listen, there's an answer for you. An answer of peace. Amen. Coming from God. You will not die. You will live to declare his words in Jesus' name. That is an answer of peace in Jesus' name. An answer of peace.
Hallelujah.
Today, you are living here with an answer of peace. Where you have been troubled, where things have failed, nobody could explain. Things looked impossible. You don't know where to go next. There is an answer of peace. When God speaks, he speaks peace. Hallelujah. Whatever has been impossible, with God is possible. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Listen, the peace of God is different from the peace of the world. The answer of peace is coming your way. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Are you troubled about school fees? Are you troubled about children? He says, the answer of peace. My children shall be taught of God. Hallelujah. My children, that's an answer of peace. My children shall be taught of God. Rest in Jesus' name. Rest in Jesus' name. Are you worried you will not get married? You are a good thing. Hallelujah. Whoever finds a wife finds a good thing. Listen. Listen. You are not as you think. You are not ordinary. You are peculiar. Hallelujah. You are peculiar. You are unique. Hallelujah. You are a good thing. You will get married. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. In Jesus' name. That is the answer of peace. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The peace we are talking about is different from the world of peace in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The peace we are talking about, Isaiah 53, verses 5. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. Hallelujah. 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 The peace we are talking about, it was at a cost. It was at a cost. Hallelujah. It was at a cost. It's not another peace. Hallelujah. It came by punishment so that it arrives to you. It's not ordinary peace. It was by punishment. The chastisement, as you said, of our peace was upon him. It was at the cost. You will not die. It was at the cost. You will not die. You will live to declare his works in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. It was at the cost. Amen. It was at the cost. Hallelujah. Listen, the peace we are talking about is different from the peace we know.
Amen.
Philippians 4:7. And the peace of God, which, hallelujah, passes all our understanding, you cannot understand, shall keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. Let me pose a question. The Bible says in Proverbs 4:23, keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it are issues of life. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it are issues of life. Now listen, he says, the peace of God which passes all understanding shall keep your heart. It has ability to keep your heart. Hallelujah. To keep your mind. Hallelujah. The troubles are there, but it has the ability to keep your heart. Because with your heart, you believe. Hallelujah. It's so important. You need that peace that is able to keep your heart. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's not an ordinary peace. It has the ability to keep your heart, to keep your mind in Jesus' name. In spite of troubles around, in spite of what is happening, listen, the peace of God that will keep your heart, hallelujah, will make you sail through in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, it doesn't just keep your heart. It has the ability to rule your heart. Amen. Colossians 3:15. That's why people have to pray to ask God to release the peace that will keep their heart, the peace that will rule their heart. Hallelujah. 3:15, he says, and let the peace, what should rule your heart? The peace of God. Are you troubled? Eh? Are you troubled? You need peace that will rule your heart. Hallelujah. Are you troubled? There is peace. God is lazy. That's going to rule your heart. That will not see the trouble in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. When your heart is ruled by God's peace, the troubles lose sense in Jesus' name. They lose direction in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As I sum it up, the peace that is from God, the peace that is above, the peace that is good and perfect, that is different. How do I get it? I need this peace. Hallelujah. It came at a cost. I need it. I shouldn't take it for granted. I should desire it. I need it so that it can keep my heart. Because my heart, the Bible says, there are issues of life. I believe with my heart. I need it to be kept. I need the peace that will rule my heart. Hallelujah. So I need it. He says, 5:1, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace. Hallelujah. With God, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace. This peace is by faith. Hallelujah. It's by faith. Amen. It's by faith. Because this faith, this peace is from God. The Bible says whoever comes to God must believe. Hallelujah. Because it's coming from God. You need this peace. That's why you need to call me Lord. I need your peace that will rule my heart. I need your peace that will rule my mind. I need your peace that will keep my heart. Because there are a lot of issues. The Bible says the world lies in wickedness. There are a lot of fears. But when the peace of God comes and keeps your heart, amen, you will not be afraid. Amen. When the peace of God comes and rules over your heart, you will not be afraid. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. You will not be afraid of sickness. You will not be afraid of accident. You will not be afraid, because his peace will rule over your heart and will go forward in Jesus' name. You will step away, never step in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This peace is an asset. It came at a cost. It came at a cost for you and me. And it takes faith. Hallelujah. To enjoy this peace. For it to rule your heart. And your life will never be the same. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Listen, as I sum up. When Joseph told Pharaoh that the answer would be of peace, things changed. Joseph went to another level. You are going to another level. Amen. You are going to another level in Jesus' name. Amen. The answer of peace, God has leased it to take you to another level in Jesus' name. You are going to step where you have never stepped. You are going to handle what you have never handled. Whatever prison you have been in, there is an answer of peace. Hallelujah. To take you to another level. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Listen. What he said. What he said. John 14, 27. Peace I leave with you. It is tangible. Amen. My peace, customized, I give unto you. Hallelujah. I give unto you. Not as the world giveth. Give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither be afraid. Hallelujah. That's how powerful this peace is. Not to be afraid. What has caused you to be afraid? What has been making you be afraid? What has caused fear? Listen, from this day forward, because of God's peace, fear, being afraid, has lost direction in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. That's why he said, I'll leave you this peace, my peace. Therefore, let not your heart be troubled. What has troubled you? What has troubled you? Are things impossible? Are things not working? There is peace from God. Don't be troubled. You'll get there. There's an out of peace. There's an out of peace in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. There is an answer of peace for someone today. There is an answer of peace for somebody here today. Somebody had given up. Somebody had given up. There is an answer of peace. God is saying, don't give up. He's with you. He will never leave you in Jesus' name. He will never leave you. He will never leave you in Jesus' name. That is an answer of peace in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Listen, there's an answer of peace for somebody who is so much engrossed on history. Things that happen. The answer of peace is, it restores the wasted years. It restores what the canker worm has eaten. It is restoring all in Jesus' name. That is the answer of peace for you today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's somebody here is trying to finish the house. Listen, the answer of peace is, he is the builder. He will finish that house. He is the author and the finisher of our faith in Jesus' name. That is an answer of peace in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's a very merciful God. He's a very merciful God. He will provide. He will not let you down. He will not let you down. In Jesus' name. I want to prophesy. There's somebody that needs this peace. I prophesy the peace of God over your life. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. There's a person troubled. Listen, the peace that God has released has removed every trouble that has been in your way. In Jesus' name. Amen. In Jesus' name.
Welcome to Kampala Bible Revelation Church, located at Makerere 1, Okubira Zone. Pastor Hanning Mutukiriza and other servants of God welcome you to a ministry based on the Word of God. We have a covenant with God for placement and multiplication according to Ezekiel 37 verse 26 to 28. Welcome to our Sunday services, which impact believers with transformational revelations from the Word of God. Our Thursday midweek service is a series of teachings equipping believers with practical skills from the Word of God. Testimonies of God's goodness abound. You can also join our Doers of the Word Bible Institute, where God's children have been ground into God's Word and empowered with a practical approach to transformation, both spiritually and physically, totally free of charge. We are located at Makerere 1, Mukubira Zone, near Makerere Business Institute, along Sapa Lokagwa Road. You are welcome.